Do you think Bonds and Clemens get in the next 3 years?
You know, I really thought so until yesterday. Peter Gammons and I were talking, and we both thought
that
Bonds and Clemens would get at least to the low 60s and probably to the mid-60s based on the substantial jump they took a year ago. But they only moved up 2 percentage points to around 59%. Now, they have 3 years left, and here are the things that could help them. Four players get in, plus Fred McGriff, who probably didn't get justice. Fred McGriff comes off because this was his 10th year of eligibility. That's five slots. Next year, Derek Jeter is the only player worthy of consideration. And in 2021, there is no additional player worthy of consideration. So that clears the logjam out. And during that period of time, a few more younger voters will come in. And as Tom Verducci pointed out yesterday, those who have become eligible to vote in the last several years are trending at 85% yes for Bonds and Clemens. And it's possible, we can't read their minds, but it's possible that some of the old line voters are going to come around in the 10th year and that their thinking was, I'm going to make them sweat. I'm going to hold my nose and vote for them in the 10th year, but not a moment before. And if those combinations come together, more space on the ballot, more new voters, old guys coming around, maybe they eke over 75, but they're not going to get 80% or anything close to it.
For more Dan Patrick Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV or download the Dan Patrick Show app.